Hello, everyone. My name is Andrew.
And I'm Kassy.
And this is the Culips English Podcast. Hey there, everyone. This is a simplified speech episode, which is the Culips series that features totally natural English conversations that are slowed down just a little bit. And today, I am joined by my co-host, Kassy. Hey there, Kassy.
Hey, Andrew.
Today, we are recording together in the same room at the same time.
Yeah, it's a real treat.
Usually, we record separately, right? But we're in the same city today, so we thought we'd get together and record. And we have an interesting topic to talk about, which was suggested to us by one of our listeners. It is swimming. So today we're going to talk all about swimming.
Which is great because swimming is one of my favorite sports.
Yeah. So this is perfect. But before we get into our conversation, we should let all of our listeners know about the study guide for this episode. Everyone, there's a study guide for this episode, and it is available on our website, culips.com, for all Culips members. Inside the guide, you will find a transcript and detailed vocabulary explanations, as well as some examples that will help you understand the key vocabulary. There's a quiz. There's lots of great stuff in there that we design to help you improve your English. So if you'd like to sign up, become a Culips member, and study with our study guides, then just visit our website, culips.com. And I also wanted to give a shout out to one of our listeners named Hayandari, who left us a really nice review on Apple Podcasts. The review says that Culips is one of the best ESL podcasts ever, and that if you are looking for some good English learning podcasts, then you should subscribe to us. So thank you again for that nice review and 5-star rating. Everyone, it really does help us out when you leave reviews like this online, wherever you listen to us, really, whether it's Apple Podcasts or any other service. So keep them coming, guys. We're going to try and shout out some of the people that leave us nice reviews here in the future. So if you want to hear your name on the podcast, just leave us a review and we'll give you a shout out in an upcoming episode. All right, let's get into it, Kassy.
Okay.
Swimming.
Yes.
Yeah, let's jump in. Maybe that's a better way.
We should dive in.
Dive in to this topic. Why don't we start by talking about how we learned how to swim? Because it's not something that comes to us naturally, right? So how did you learn how to swim? Did you take swimming lessons? Did your parents teach you?
So my mom, I think a lot of parents in America, but my mom especially, thought swimming was an extremely necessary skill. So I actually started swimming before I could walk. My mom and I went to mommy and me swim classes when I was a baby.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And then I started to really swim on my own when I was 5. I joined a swim team.
Mm-hmm. So I guess you don't even remember learning how to swim, really.
Nope. I was like a fish, you know, just very natural.
I've seen that on TV before when I guess it's usually mothers are with their infants in the swimming pool.
Yep, that's right.
There's that iconic Nirvana album cover shot too that comes to mind of the baby in the swimming pool. Wow, that's wild. So you have been a swimmer then pretty much all your life.
Yep, that's right. I think it's because my mom really loved swimming, so she wanted to show me that love, have me like it too.
And it worked.
Yeah. How about you, Andrew? How did you learn to swim?
I took swimming lessons as well. It's really common in Canada for almost every kid to learn how to swim by taking swimming lessons mm-hmm. at the local YMCA pool.
Mm-hmm.
So I remember having to take swimming lessons in the evenings after school when I was 6, 7, 8 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And I hated it. I remember asking my mom, like, oh, do I have to go? Can I skip it this week? I just never liked swimming, and I have bad memories about it, but for no good reason. Like, swimming lessons were fine. I just didn't enjoy it. But they worked. I learned how to swim, so.
Well, that's something.
I'm glad I have that skill now.
Yeah. Did you learn every stroke? So in swimming, there's 4 main strokes: freestyle, backstroke, breaststroke, and butterfly.
I learned the most important stroke, which was not sinking. That stroke. I learned all of the strokes, I think. But now, these days, when I go swimming, I usually just use the freestyle stroke, mm-hmm. which is the one where you kind of put your arms in front of your body and propel yourself forward, almost like your arms are in a windmill motion,
mm-hmm.
right? I like that one. And I also like the frog style stroke.
The breaststroke.
Breaststroke.
Yes.
Yes. I think breaststroke is my go-to stroke. If I'm just swimming around, and then if I want to go faster, I go for the
freestyle.
Yeah.
How about the doggy paddle?
Doggy paddle. Yeah. Funnily enough, my girlfriend is, it's so weird. She knows how to swim because she took swimming lessons as an adult, and she can swim quite strongly doing the strokes that you just mentioned, but she can't just kick around in a swimming pool for fun. And so I was teaching her how to do the doggy paddle recently, and she couldn't pick it up. Yeah, that was the first time in a long time that I did the doggy paddle so that I could demonstrate to her, how to do it.
Yeah.
But she didn't get it. It's really weird. I don't know how she can swim well and still not master the most basic mm-hmm. strokes. She also can't float on her back.
Oh, that's like my favorite thing to do in the summer, just float on my back and look up at the blue sky.
Yeah. Yeah, she says it's amazing. Like, she's shocked that I can just float in the water without moving. But yeah, that's also my favorite. I like doing it at night. I know night swimming is a little bit dangerous. Be careful, everyone. But yeah, looking up at the sky and looking at the stars, floating, it's pretty good.
Where is your favorite place to swim?
Favorite place to swim. I don't go swimming very often. I hardly ever go to a swimming pool because I don't really swim for exercise. It's more of just something to do while I'm on vacation mm-hmm. or if it's a really hot day out, I'll go swimming to cool down. So that usually means that I'm in the ocean or in a lake. I prefer swimming in nature, especially freshwater. Swimming in lakes in Canada, to me, is the best place to swim.
Yeah, it's interesting. I think a lot of people have a very strong preference, like only swimming in a pool or only swimming in nature.
Yeah, I actually do hate that chlorine feeling that's on your skin after swimming in a swimming pool. Even if you shower a couple times, it still feels kind of stuck to your skin, or that your skin has been shocked a little bit.
Have you ever heard that blonde-haired people, if they swim in a swimming pool too often, their hair will turn green?
I have heard that.
It is literally true.
Really?
Yeah. When I was younger, my hair was much blonder than it is now. And It did have a slight green tint to it for
a while. No
way. Oh, it was awful.
What about you, Kassy? Do you prefer to swim in a swimming pool or in a lake or the ocean?
I prefer swimming pools for exercise and then oceans for fun. Lakes, they're kind of silty. Like, there's a lot of dirt in the water, so I don't like that.
Okay. And how often do you swim these days?
I took a couple of years off from swimming, but just recently I joined a swimming pool again, and I've been going 3 or 4 times a week.
3 or 4 times a week.
Yeah.
Wow, so you are a very avid swimmer.
Yes. Wow. I feel like I'm flying when I swim almost.
Yeah, you must be really good then if you swim that often.
No.
Have you ever competed? Like, have you ever raced?
Yeah, I was on a swim team from 5 years old until senior year of high school.
Wow.
So I did a lot of competitions. I was never like super good, but I have a lot of, you know, second place, third place, fourth place ribbons.
That's pretty good. Second place, third place. That's not too shabby.
Yeah.
That's really good. So when you go swimming, then, you must really look like a professional swimmer. Do you wear swim cap and goggles and earplugs and nose plugs?
Are
nose plugs a thing? I don't know.
I think some people wear them, but no, I do not wear the nose plugs or the earplugs. But
okay.
the cap, the goggles, and especially in high school, it was like a fashion statement. Like, girls would have a swimsuit for each day of the week with different colors and swim caps with like their favorite logos or cartoons on them. It was really fun.
I've been hanging out with some friends from the UK recently, and both of my friends swim. And I recently heard them talking about swimming, and I was laughing at them because do you know what British people call a swimming pool?
What?
They call it the swimming baths. They go to the swimming baths to exercise.
I'm going to go take a bath.
Yeah. So I was actually a little confused because I thought they were talking about like a public bath, like a sauna type thing. But no, I guess that's just what people in the UK call a swimming pool. A public swimming pool is called the swimming baths.
Huh.
So I learned something new.
Yeah, I didn't know that either.
Yeah. All right, Kassy. Well, I think we can wrap things up here. Thanks for sharing your swimming stories with us.
Anytime.
And thank you to the listener who requested this topic. And any other listeners out there, if you guys have a topic that you would like us to discuss, then please get in touch with us and let us know. Our email address is contact@culips.com, or you could also send us a message through your favorite social media website. We are on all of them, on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook, and on YouTube. So if you leave us a comment or send us a message through social media, then we'll be sure to see it. If you enjoy studying with Culips and if you learn a lot with us, then please help us out and support us. You can do that by leaving a nice review and a 5-star rating wherever you get your podcasts. You could tell your friends about Culips, or you could sign up and become a Culips member. And again, to do that, just visit culips.com. We will be back soon with another brand new episode, and we'll catch you then. Goodbye.
See you later.